Hi people, welcome to this video. We are going to see how to use Lightworks 12 in a few and short steps. Leave us comments to improve our videos. Lightworks is basically a video editing software to create your own video projects, collecting and modifying other files you have already. When you just open the software, the project browser appears. This collects all your existing projects made. You can also create a new project. Just type a name and leave frame rate as auto. Then just go to create below. Your project must have a collection of files imported. With the new window, choose any image, sound file or video you need inside. All formats not read don't appear in the list. To select more files, just hold Ctrl down and click on them. Then just go to Import below. These files, called clips, will appear inside a File Manager window that collects them all in a clear list. You can add more files going on Tools on the left and clicking on the second icon. Each file is listed with full names and a small preview on the left. These are the most recent files you added. Just select a different filter on the left to have a full list of the clips added in your project. You can check better each file added, double-clicking on the small preview. This opens a small player to check your clip better. Usually, the length of videos and sound files is defined by their own duration, while the duration of images is set at 1 minute by default. The red rhombus below indicates the playhead. Keep in mind the two buttons on the extreme right. Use the first icon to check any metadata, and the second icon to open the clip's timeline. This does depend on the kind of clip you are seeing. If you are checking an image, just a video track V1 appears. If you are checking a sound file, two audio tracks do appear, A1 and A2, one for the left stereo channel, the other for the right one. In case of videos, you will have all both audio tracks and plus a video track. We are going to see these tracks shortly. Let's have a look on the workspace. As you can see, there is a clear basic background that then is filled with any opened window you have. These windows are different, and each of them can be opened through the Tools panel on the left. Each of these can be moved by clicking and dragging them. If you click on the drawing pin icon in the top right corner, you will fix the window where it is, until you click again on such icon. Use the shrink button to make the window smaller. To enlarge it again, double-click on its borders or click on the enlarge button. You can also put clips shrinked apart on your background to check or add them later or make comparisons. Once clips are added, you can start creating your project. To do this, you need a main timeline. If you click on the third icon in Tools, the Edit or Log window appears. You can create as many edit windows as you want, each recognized by a number on top. Just click on it to type a name. It is better if you fix one of the edit windows as a main one, which will collect your project in full. Each edit window is composed by two parts: the preview that we have seen before with the clips imported, and the timeline. Both of them are linked with the same name, but you can move and place them independently. We must focus on the timeline. Is this you use to create your personalized project. A timeline is composed by different rows, called the tracks. There are the video tracks, indicated by a V plus a number, that can have inside videos and images, so anything visible. The audio tracks welcome sound and video sounds only, and are recognized on the left by a letter A plus a number. You can add your clips dragging them inside, also directly from the file manager. Notice the videos that have sound do occupy both video and audio tracks, and the video sound moves along the video frames together. The playhead, which is the red indicator, sets what the preview is showing. You can place it by clicking right above the tracks, or simply dragging it if you want to check any transition inside your project. Use the zoom buttons on the left to zoom in and out around the playhead. The playhead position on top is set by a red rhombus, while the white strip indicates the part of your project you are currently watching with your tracks below. You can also turn on and off a track clicking on its name on the left. A track switched off is locked, so that you can't edit or move any clip that is inside it. You can use this to split audio from video frames. Just lock the video track and move the audio parts. These will become independent. You can change the track names or delete one right-clicking on them and going to track commands. Use edit commands to add or delete other tracks. The edit window shows a project that lasts 30 minutes by default, as you can check from the preview. You can adjust the length of the preview by fixing the blue rhombuses more at the bottom. Define the starting point and the ending point. You will create a selected area. Then, if you click on the second icon below, you will delete such area and so reduce the total length. Make sure to delete just parts that do not have any clip inside. Let's now edit clips. First of all, it is better to enlarge the timelines and the tracks to work better. Just drag the window's contours and the edges of the tracks interested. To move clips along its track or in another track, drag it when a small, double black arrow appears close to your pointer when you hover the clip around itself. In case you have clips overlapping on different tracks, it is shown the clip on the upper video track first, remember. To remove clips, simply right-click on the clip on itself. Go to Source Clip and then to Remove. You can also use Delete, with the difference that also the empty space left on the timeline by the clip is deleted, as the icon suggests. Let's see some quick important things. You can first create a copy of a clip by dragging it while holding Ctrl down. This works if you start dragging when the double black arrow appears close to your pointer. Mind that clips that do overlap on the same track are completely cut off. You can undo and redo your actions using the arrows in the top right corner. To split a clip in two, place the playhead on the exact point and press the letter X from your keyboard. This does work on all clips listed. If you want to split just one clip, just lock all tracks you don't want to be affected. Another very important thing in Lightworks is how to stretch clips. First of all, do place the red playhead near the edge you want to stretch. Then, if you hover near such edge, your pointer will show a white symbol in a corner. If you click once, you will unjoin the clip from its track, which means, in short, that your clip is ready to be stretched in time. To use this in the easiest way possible, make sure that just one clip is unjoined and you start dragging where you meet an H white symbol. If you don't do in this way, you may stretch the track instead or change behavior. When you finish stretching, just click on Join below. Keep in mind that if you stretch videos and sound over their natural duration, the clips will be stretched using silent and blank frames added. When your edit is done, you can close it. It remains saved. The important thing to keep in mind is that once the edit is done, it behaves like a more complex clip that you can add inside another edit timeline. So you can simply use the main edit to collect all the other edit clips already adjusted and defined. Let's see how to export your project. Your project is kept saved already, but your final video is not out yet. To export your video, keep open the edit window to export and go to the seventh icon inside Tools. Choose in Content, under Logs, what is the edit timeline to render. Choose your edit main if this collects your full project. In Format, choose All Video Settings and in Destination choose where and with which name save the video. When you are ready, just go to Start below. The video will be exactly like the edit chosen, will be blank where the edit has no clips, and finishes where the timeline does finish. Remember to use the icon in the very top left corner to save and exit from your current project to run another one. This is all. Check out our guides in our channel for more.